You knew this in Brave and the Bold. Well, you're going to love it when it goes into the DC Universe, because it's letting us open the vault by rebranding the minis in DC Universe in that 2 1/4 scale. You're going to see way increased articulation. I'm talking ball joint articulation. Available as 2-packs, Heroes and Villains, the Battle of the Pamir Hand, and many of the figures are going to tie closely to recent and upcoming comic storylines like never before. In this line, you're going to see Superman vs. Bizarro, another flying pose. You're going to see Firestorm and Black Lantern Firestorm. You're going to see Flash versus the new Captain Boomerang. You're going to see Green Lantern versus White Lantern Sinestro. Green Arrow and Prometheus. Bill has a personal favorite here. Bill Benedict, by the way, designed all of these characters. And the new Batman and Joker. More of a comic style Joker. Now that it's DC Universe and not Brave and the Bold. Oh, and of course we have to get Jon Stewart on the Joker. Followed by Tor, Rey, and Love. I think there might be a Green Lantern thing, though. DC Retro Action Figures. You guys like these? We have a little bit of figures. There's a lot more coming down the pipe. You're going to see these are the 8-inch cloth figures you remember from your childhood. New waves of 2011, available at both Toys R Us and those same select online retailers, what we call the Emerging Channel Group. The next wave is going to be Flash with Captain Cold. We've seen Wonder Woman, and we're going to pair her with Cheetah. Wave 4, coming in spring 11, you're going to see Shazam, Captain Marvel, Black Adam, Martian Manhunter, and really cool Darkseid. I never had this treatment. Amazing. Years waiting for that. Also, there's going to be a special Green Lantern retro action line exclusively on Magic Collector. There'll be one figure per month starting in February of 11, counting down to the movie release. We have the first two to sneak peek. So in the Green Lantern retro action online, first you're going to get Modern Sinestro, and then Guy Gardner. All right, Infinite Heroes. So you've seen at Comic-Con the amazing Starro Pack. You guys want the Starro Pack?
Yeah.
So you get the whole crew from the cover of Brave and the Bold 28, including the Bendy Starro, and only at this show you'll want to get the Starros because they fit on your 6-inch figures. That won't be online, I'll add it in a second. Where's Infinite Heroes going in 2011? Well, we don't have much we can reveal right now, but for fans of the 3 3/4 scale, we've got a lot in store for 2011. All we can say right now, but we got big plans. DC versus Masters. Pairing of a DC figure and Masters, they'll include one repaint in each pack exclusively at Toys R Us. You've seen the first two packs, Superman versus He-Man, and Skeletor versus Luthor. We'll have 6 in total for 2011. The first two will be Hawkman and Stratos. Rick Stratus has reverse colored wings, just like in the vintage line. Hawkman is exact straight issue. And Merman and Aquaman. We'll know the gold belt on Aquaman. For a family.
And gold metallic, I'm sure. Or I should say copper.
So yes, we did, per fan request, do a little touch base on RG. And Merman is in his mini comics colors for those here. All right, classics. Plastic Band here in San Diego Comic Con. Everyone got Plastic Band? You can mix and match in any kind of way. There's tons of different books. And only at Comic Con you can get the suitcase. Oh, I'm sorry. We're jumping right into the main one. All right. 2011, we have four mainline waves. One wave will be in Walmart. It's part of the retail game. You gotta do exclusives, I know. It's part of the retail game to get it out there. Six figures per wave with a Collecting Connect bonus figure. All the highly detailed, sculpted by the IP version. That'll be followed up by the Creeper.
Ooh.